And we are back. We're playing games 6 and 7 tonight with the Fishes. Take a quick look at the standings. Fish rolling 4-1 in the season. Absolutely killing it the last few games. We got a rematch versus the Sox. Remember, we played Boston a couple weeks ago back in Fenway. We took them 4-0. Pretty solid game all around. Let's just get right into it. Starting her up. A couple changes to the lineup here. Let's see. We got move. We're going to move. Pete not really doing a whole lot at second. So we're going to do that. Dante, too. I feel like he's not. Here we go. A bit of this. A bit of that. There we go. Second base. You put your worst fielder at second base because the ball's not getting into her. Who they got? Nomar. Rosanna Phelps on the mound. Pete Wheel is going to be leading us off. You need the speed to start the game. Pablo coming in second. Remember last game, Pablo hit the ball 800 feet to win the game.
Hello, baseball fan.
Take it away, Sonny.
Along with my good friend, Vinny the Gooch.
Thanks, and Vin. Sonny. It's good to be here for another exciting game of baseball. I can't get enough of it. Today we'll see.
Don't know why we're the Blue Fishes,
the Boston Red Sox,
but this is where we're at.
This season has been so.
Alright, we're skipping it. There's too much detail there.
Play ball.
It's unnecessary.
Pitching today is Angela Del Vecchio.
She pitches better
turn
against
this down
kids
a tad.
French and write poetry verses. And rumor has it, she's not a big fan of Brussels sprouts.
Really? That's weird. My parents told me all kids like Brussels sprouts.
No waste.
Oh man, are you a sucker?
Yeah. The Brussels sprout fans are going to be pissed about that one, but they suck. Alright, Cindy Chang leading off the game. Here we go. First pitch. And that's up there. Kenny, easy out. Apparently that hit the ground. That bounced. How? Alright, well, not the start you want. When the first pitch is a base hit that you didn't see hit the ground, but whatever. Pull him in, looking for the double play ball from Steph. Stephanie Morgan, not known for her speed. Batting 166 on the season. Kind of a rough start to the first five games. And that's two. I just clicked at random. That's not what you want to do. That's bad. Alright, awful that we got Cindy Chang just walking around the bases. As Big Ange Del Vecchio winds, deals, delivers, the 0-2. That ball's in play. That's foul. That's foul ball. So you got to look. Big Ange on this season has had a couple of top-tier performances. She has the ability to put teams out and shut them out fast. However, that ball's live. However, she does have a couple of poor outings here and there. Last outing against the Sox, though, pitching a shutout, four-run ball. Pretty sure she had 10-plus Ks. Knows how to dominate this team. Should do the same this time around. Dante's got to... He's right there. He's got to make that catch. That is not it. That's not it. And that's not how you want to come back from... Don't know what Nomar is doing, because he's dead. Still, gave up a run. Compose, much better outing from Angela last time. That one's got to be caught, though. Dante's got to make that. That's 3-0. Dante's got to make that catch. He's got to put the onus on getting in front of the ball, getting under it. He's hot-dogging. He's hot-dogging. Literally hot-dogging. So, the good news is, though, the bats have started to wake up for the Blue Fishes. Pete Wheeler, leading off batting 562. That's a number that we're only going to see go up. He's been big about just putting balls in play and getting on base. If memory serves, Pablo, too, is batting somewhere about 600. We keep that number above 500-600. This team is destined for great things. It's a slow bouncer. All right. All right, they made the play. Oh, both are batting 562. But at home, Pablo has a much better time at the plate than he did the first three games we were on the road. Against the Sox, I don't think he really had a big hit round one. But it's home field. Pablo, much better playing the games at home. That's gone! Didn't even get all of it. Doesn't matter. Pablo ties it up with one swing of the bat. And we, 553, no power up needed. Just absolutely crushed that ball to dead center. 1-1. Fish is back in it. Pablo getting his groove on. Mind you, we're playing with no pitch marker or no indicator. So not only do I not know where the ball is, I don't even get the zone for the general idea of where the ball is. Because this game was made for children, so I'm trying to make it challenging. And I did lose a game, so there was a little bit of challenge in this game. That's trouble. Not trouble. She's out. Everybody who's tuning into the stream, thanks for tuning in. Hope you got to catch Pablo's absolute moonshot in the bottom of the first inning. We are cruising here with the last division game of the season. It's game number 6. The Fish is coming in with a 4-1 record. With their loss in the year coming to the O's. Angel Delvecchio had a rough first inning. Gave up a couple of long shots. Nomar gave her an easy out at third base with poor, poor base running. Is that trouble? We getting down? We getting down? Not getting down. Alright. Rosanna Phelps. She's been the pitcher for the Sox the whole season. Not a good hitter. But she pitches. So that's all that matters.
Nice one. That's what I like to see.
So I shut this off last time. I have to turn this back on. I made a mistake. I accidentally shut the chatter off last time because it was getting to me, but it's too silent. We need some voices. We need some people in the field talking shit. We need we want a batter, not a broken ladder. We need the chatter. I don't know what that was, Sally Dobbs, but probably sticked with doing that at home. That's not something you want to do out in public. Oh, that ball's crushed. That's gone. Unless it's get top of the wall. It's out of here. Wow. We're not watching their home runs. They don't get the benefit. If I give up a home run to Butch Sherrod, who's batting goose egg through 5 games, we got a problem. Big Ange is not bringing her best stuff today. And she's not going to bring her best stuff every game. Some point in time, you got to rely on your lineup. You got to rely on the bats. And Pete's going to have to step up. Pablo's going to have to keep the hot streak hot. We need some hits from Sally Dobbs. Absolute laser from Pablo. Here we go now, kid. That poor kid, he was like me in the Little League. He's batting zero through 6 games, and the rest of his team, you know they hate him for it. He's not a good fielder. He's not a good hitter. He stinks. Oh, Kenny with a laser, too. That's 3. All right. Dante Robinson, who may have cost us a run in the first inning, possibly double play ball. Because he was busy hot-dogging. But I was mistaken. Today it's a hamburger. Okay, we got a little lettuce, tomato. Could be some ketchup on there. Again, with the amount of food he eats, you'd think he'd be a little bit heavier. Over the pitcher's head. Right at her. Okay, good catch. There is no way Sally Dobbs starts with the open stance and that this is comfortable. Look at her feet. I mean, that pitch is coming in, so it's a perfect pitch to hit with the stance she has. But there's no way this is comfortable. There's no bend to the knees. Look at the back leg. Straight. Is that trouble? Is it trouble? Nope. Her pitcher's playing a hell of a game. Big Ange. She's got some pop in this bat. She actually, I think, may have a home run in the season. But for the most part, not a great hitter. Absolutely no speed either. She's not known for her movement around the bases. Yeah, see, this is an out. I don't care how they could take their time with this one. That's the only way it gets out of play. She gets handed second base. And Kenny Kawaguchi having a rough season right now. Game 6. He's batting 7-6. 76, rather. That's, somebody hit me with some quick math there. What is that, 1 for 11? 12? Not a good season for Ken to start, but you know what? Pitchers painting corners against him. He's the back end of a strong rotation, strong lineup. I think I'm getting jammed on that one. Even if I don't swing. Brett Olson. So the Sox have two guys who are batting zero on the season. And as far as memory serves, this game is very, very generous with what's a hit and what's an error. So, can't give up to hits the guy's batting zero. Or the girl's batting zero, either way. Need to take advantage. 0-2. Big Ange coming in with the heater. Got him. No. Pop him up. Kenny, get there. Get there, Kenny. Oh! This is rough. Like Cindy Chang with a base hit. All right. Batting 312. I can respect the base hit there. We're pulling up. We're looking for a double play ball here. So, you get the double play ball here. You get handed a special hit. Usually it's not the aluminum bat, but you still get a special hit. No, it's not. Just hold it and go back to the mound. Yeah, that's... I'm still leaving. I'm going to shift him over to third. Try to pick up the runner at third. Especially if I keep throwing. She wants to throw the left hook. Let's try to paint the corner on the outside. If we get the outside, we can get her hit it down the line. Or strikeout looking. The strikeout looking is big. Alright. One down. Stephanie Morgan, usually a staple on my team, somehow didn't get drafted this year. Replaced with Lisa Crockett, Sally Dobbs, and two sisters. Just check him on third. Check him on third. No double play, but two dead. Nomar actually 0 for 1, which is wild because he actually hit a double and got thrown out on third. So, Big Ange, too. No special pitches. No special pitches through three full innings. It's probably the longest I've ever gone without a special pitch.
No way.
That pitch was insane. Getting that call, too, is bullshit, but I'll take it. She's got it. Don't let it hang. Don't let it hang. That's three. That's strike three. All right. It's all right. Outside. Oh, he's it. He's going to crush this. No thanks. Just looking from Nomar. Go now, kid. Big Ange with her second K of the game. Should get a special pitch. Lisa Crockett with what a lot of people are calling the double of the century in the last game. Lisa Crockett looks like she'd grow up to do your taxes. Not a knock on her, that's just facts. Alright, the breaking ball there from Rosanna was sick. That ball started off behind the lefty batter box. We gotta keep in mind, too, that with one strikeout, Miss Phelps may have a special pitch. That's high. Good eye. Good eye, Lisa. Here we go now, kid. Here we go now. Lisa puts the ball in play. A little bit dangerous because Pete's got way too much speed behind her. That's high. Same pitch. If she gets on, we gotta get her moving because Pete's gonna catch her, and we can't let that happen. That's an out. That's a free out. That's lower. Also big in this game is working the pitcher. Eventually she's gonna run out of juice as long as we don't keep giving her K's. All right. That's not an easy play. She's got to hustle out there.
That's an out.
It's an easy play. She didn't have to hustle out there. Pete Wheeler, being a lefty and having speed that's unmatchable and the IQ of a rock makes him one of the best players that's ever played this game. That hurt. That didn't break back. Never get him. That's at least one. Pete's looking to push this to two, and he's got it easy. We'll hold it too. Pete probably could have crawled with the speed he's got. Let's go, Pablo. Pablo going 2 for 2 with 2 dingers would be an absolute statement to the rest of the league. Good eye. Good eye, kid. Absolute bush league if they walk this kid. Oh, no. He's dead. That's an out. Alright. Alright. Respect. Pablo's got at least one more at bat, though. We can go hitless the rest of the game. Pablo's going to be up in the bottom of the last. He ain't catching him. They ain't catching this kid. Oh, and that... Wow. Okay. Nice play, Rosanna. Nice catch. Alright. We do. So, I'm playing this game on an emulator right now that loves to crash. So, because of that, we do the 3-inning save, we do the final out save. So there's a quick save, so now we have it forever starting the top of the 4th, down 2-1. All stats are final, and we're not cheating. Alright, here we go. Jim Kiley taking the 0-2. 0-1, rather. Foul ball, Kiley looking at 0-2. Delvecchio's got him right where she wants him. She's going to look to drop the left hook in here. On the break. Absolute cheese. Gets him swinging over the top. Kiley down on strikes. That's 0-2 on the day. Rosanna Phelps, another one, struggling at the plate. She's batting 0-76. First pitch. Here it is. Delvecchio winds, delivers. That's 0-1. Delvecchio, not known for her heaters, but mixes them in once in a while. More known for her off-speed stuff. Traditionally good at the left-right hook. And that slow ball is hit with such precision that you're almost guaranteeing yourself a strike when you throw it close to the corners. Tough to hit. Tough for these kids to get on top of this ball. And if you noticed, Rosanna opened up the stance on that pitch. So she's fully expecting another slow ball up and inside. However, she's getting hit with junk. This is when she comes in with junk outside, swinging. Look at that. That is paint on the corner. Mrs. Phelps couldn't hit that if I told her where it was going. That pitch is absolutely incredible from Big Ange. Tracy Hoban. Not somebody you think of as a notoriously great hitter. 230 on the season. But she crushed that first ball. Okay, I'm very confused on what happened there because that was out of the possible zone of where the pitch was going. Vinny said it almost hit the batter. It didn't. It was in the other batter's box. That might have been a glitch. We're going to let that go. This is what I wanted. Okay. So she's now stepping forward. Now you want to... Wow. Big Angie's going to challenge her. She wants to challenge her with the right hook. Outside the zone coming in. That's crushed. Oh, Lisa laying out. All right. The Weber sisters. Pretty good. Pretty good hitters, notoriously. Having both of them on the... Oh, it's a little bit underneath. Okay. I was above it. Having both the Weber sisters on the team increases their stats tremendously. They become nearly as good as Pablo. You know, sometimes you have a brain fart, you hit a little ground ball, a little number to the pitcher. Happens. But in the field, they can pitch, they can hit, they can pretty much do anything. Ball. So I don't know where the line is that's a strike, because that's been called a strike on me before, it's been called a strike for me before, but... That's clear. Rosanna Phelps, she's looking at a 2-0 here on Dante. Dante's going to bring out the power bat. She makes one mistake here, and we're looking at a tie ball game. That could be it. And he swings underneath it tremendously. Dante looked stupid out there with that swing. It's all right. It's all right. It's only 2-1. Now she's got him on the ropes. 2-2. Dante from looking 2-0. Had all control in this at bat. Now he's looking absolutely lost. Hits a little pop-up to the pitcher. That's all he's getting out of this. Oh, an absolute laser from the third baseman. Dante going to take off because there's nobody at second. That's a miscommunication and a poor play. Free base from Dante. If that doesn't drill her in the back of the head, we're going 3, maybe 4. Come on, Sally kid. With one out, you want to get Dante around the bases and back in. There's no promise that you will, but that's what you want. That's a slow ball. Not a slow ball. Well, it's a slow ball, but not as slow-mo. Because there's still a special pitch out there. I don't know what she has. She hasn't thrown it yet. How the fuck am I supposed to hit that? That was at her hat, which is a good 7 inches above her head. That's got to be high, right? Okay. So, 2-1 here. Rosanna's kind of losing it a little bit. She's been all over the zone. She's very sporadic. Hasn't walked anybody, but that's because I swing at everything. Oh, look at the read. Look at the shift being on. They're going to say that hit the ground. I'm not sure how, but... We got Sally on first. Angela gets credit with a double. Let's remember, she hit a ground ball to right field so slow, if the throw was decent, she was out. The only reason she got two bases is because she went out of play. It's got to be an infield fly.
Yeah.
It's an infield fly because you got Dante on second, Sally on first, less than two outs. Although that ball might have been too deep for the infield fly rule, especially in this league. But it is what it is. We're going to send him and see what happens because Kenny's not that guy. No. What is going on? Everyone go back to your bases. All right, come on, Kenny. Just put the ball in play. Make them make a play. That's all we want. You don't got to be a hero. Oh, Kenny, you're a hero if you get on base here.
That little blooper sent him running.
Kenny gets on base. He's safe. That's huge. That's huge because that means we hit a special pitch of hers, so we get a special hit. This isn't who you want to use it with, but the bases are loaded. Screw it. Send him. Lisa Crocket to be the hero again. Has to be. Lisa Crockett, who I said was probably one of the worst picks I've ever had in this game, hits an undergrounder that very well may be a grand slam. Nomar with a laser home. Bang, bang, play at the plate. Stephanie Morgan not paying attention. Wow. Wow. Lisa Crockett, your hero again. The Blue Fishes, who, by the way, terrible name for an entirely pink team. But Lisa Crockett flips this game on its head with an undergrounder. And that's your 8-9 hitters. That's Kenny Kawaguchi getting the spitball hit. And that's Lisa Crockett, your 9. Okay. That's her third spitball with one strikeout. How many special pitches is this lady getting?
Butch Sharon. Look at him. Gritting his teeth. Ready to
Butch just looks like that right smug kid that you want to punch in the face.
Ready now. The 1-1 pitch. And popped up.
Drop. Drop. Was it a good drop?
And
another drop.
And the fourth inning's over.
Fourth inning's over. But that is a monster inning. And you got to remember, we're stacking these. We're stacking all those up for the last inning. And we have more juice. So what we're going to do is we're going to try to get out of this inning quick, get to the sixth, and just start K-ing kids left and right. I mean, if we think we're getting more strikeouts, we can use these because they'll be replaced with the new strikeout boost. But Butch Sherrod's still batting goose egg, so. Like, is it necessary right now to drill a fireball? This is beyond unnecessary, but we can. Thanks, Butch. Thanks for playing. Butch just not having a great season. Like I said, batting zero through six games now. Six games he's batting goose egg. Like, his parents, they come to these games, they want to see him get on base, they want to see him get a hit. It's just not on the cards for old Butchie. It's not going to happen for him. Big Ange with another fastball. Another K. Brett Olson, I gave up his first hit today. That ain't it, Chief. That is not it. Sorry. That's nothing. So, the full the juice is going to give me a full bar. So, we now have free reign to keep throwing a bunch of stupid pitches at kids. Is that him? So, Butch, there's no way he's hitting this. Oof. So, Butch got his first hit of the season against us today. To follow that up, we're going to make him think about it, freeze, and then K him up.
Halfway through the inning.
Done.
Pablo Sanchez steps in. Even though the secret weapon doesn't speak any English, we all know he's a rad dude.
Fun fact, if you go to the cards after the game, I'm pretty confident Pablo speaks English. I don't know if it's in this one or the original one. Oh, he's going to leg that out. There's no way they're getting him. Hell of a throw from Steph. Hell of a throw from Steph. I don't know why he called her that. Awkward. Come on, Butch. We're looking to kind of just move through this game at this point, because it's not over. Hold on, I'm just trying to set something up here. But this game, for all intents and purposes, with the way Big Ange is pitching, the number of special pitches we got, this game's over. Alright. You don't want to start giving them K's, though, build momentum. You don't want them to feel good about themselves. Alright. All you gotta do is put it in play. Let him make the play. See, Butch, like you said, rough season. Did he need to throw that at a million miles a minute to some girl? No. Alright, here we go, Ash. Here you go, Ashley. Oh, got underneath it. Hey, Sydney, why are you going so slow? Oh, that's why, because there's only one out. I thought there's two. Let's put in play, Dante. We're just looking to move on to the next. The people came to see the big games. Not the blowouts.
Swung too late.
Quick checks. Two strikes. Strikeout doesn't even really matter. because I shouldn't get up again. It's unfortunate, but it's not the end of the world. I'll never see that special pitch. Oh, that juice is the worst thing you could have if you're the Sox. Because that means I can just throw all of these with reckless abandon and still have the juice to keep throwing more. She had 1K through 3. And if I'm correct, has then struck out everyone. I'm gonna have to go back and rewatch that in the stream. But to this point, I think Ange Delvecchio has struck out everybody in innings 4, 5, and currently 6. Swing and chase here is the worst thing she could do. I'll hit her with a corkscrew. Woo, 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 woo.
She tried the corner on this.
Alright. Might not get the K here. This is a tough at bat. Because I'm dedicated to the K game. We let it go. Slow mo. No way she hits this, right? That's 9. No more. She's got full juice. We're filling her up. No more's gonna have to hit one of these, which is just, for the most part, unfortunate. Oof. And we still got 4 left to choose from. The ball just jumped at him. Now it's coming in at 2 miles an hour. Oh, that's 3. Son of a bitch. Son of a bitch, and I knew it too. Oh my god. I said I'd do the last out save, and I didn't. And the game, on cue, crashes. Let's go see where we're at in this game. I think it's top 4, right? And I'm losing? Son of a bitch. Oh. For everybody looking to tune into the stream, you're getting some free baseball tonight, because we're doing this again. And I didn't click to use that. I hit escape. And my fat fingered the 1. For what it's worth, Big Ange finished that game with 10 Ks. So that means she striked out 8 out of 9. In innings 4, 5, and 6. I can't believe it just happened. Let's see if we can do it again. We'll see if we can do it again. It's going to be challenging, especially to get the Ks. Not to mention, we're trailing. K her up. We're gonna move this one along a little bit faster than I moved the original game. Because I have no patience to play this game again. Especially because I won. I think I fucked it up, I'll be honest with you. Alright, that's pretty much how it went last time in the 4th. A 1-2-3. That was met with little resistance from the Sox. And 2Ks. Is that going to drop? That's trouble. He trapped it with his glove. Ashley goes to second. Alright. So the stats are going to be tremendously skewed because people will never remember. It doesn't make the record books. Lisa Crockett actually... Go, Ashley. Lisa Crockett actually hit a grand slam. Instead, we're going to get Dante Robinson to be the hero with a standing triple to tie it.
Vinny the Gooch loving that. triple. Man, that kid is fast.
So he gets a triple.
Belly dog, runner on third,
but
with nobody out.
I'm like, this game is being played under protest, mostly by the Lisa Crockett family. That's right. Because we got an undergrounder because of that pitch. We're not going to get the undergrounder unless she throws that pitch again. And the odds of me not striking out her throwing that pitch again, slim, with the rest of the lineup to come up. I mean, the goal here is to just stay alive. Spitball's probably the easiest one of the special pitches to hit. It doesn't move that much. And if you're generally in the zone, you make contact with it. Getting on base at all, even if it's an error, counts as a hit for that.
So.
But, oh my god, the stats will be tremendously skewed. Unless... Send him. You send him. Never get Dante on this one. They got Dante on that one. Wow. Made them make the play and they did it. Respect. Oh, that's unfortunate. Shit. I can't believe that happened. Not Dante getting out of the plate. That's bang bang. I gotta send him. Make him make the play. But just the crash.
Anytime you get that second strike on you, it gets pretty tough to fight.
And the count is...
So, I mean, this is when this makes its way to the YouTubes. Lisa Crockett will be known as a hero. But only briefly. Because her numbers will be taken away. However, and this is very important to note, when the bottom of the fourth inning of the game is now tied, Lisa is guaranteed a minimum of one more at bat. No. Oh no. Oh no. Get there, Sally. Okay. New Angela was out. Needed not a double play. Kenny Kawaguchi. She's throwing at him. So, Kenny had one of the big hits of the canceled game, as we'll call it. So she throws him a spitball. That's foul, right? Yeah.
They have a runner on second, two outs.
All right. Here's a reason for this.
Pitch on the way. Ball two.
That one was just a bit wide.
Let her be out. I don't really care.
And she's out.
And it's a long walk.
And the fourth inning.
That might have seemed like a dumb play, but there is an unintentional method to that madness. So Big Ange cannot get double digit K's anymore unless we go to extras, which I have no intention of doing here. The strikeout record for the season, because we're getting it, by the way, will be under protest. With this needed to be 10. So, needed to be 10 to match what it was originally when we played this game. And Nate Kowalski gets that? Get out of here. That was supposed to be 5. I mean, it's an out, but that's not supposed to happen. Oh, this is painful. Painful watching Big N just suffer with the stats. That's 2. Hit him with the slow-mo? Maybe? He's got to swing over the top. He's batting night yet. Yeah, okay.
Halfway through the inning now. Next up.
Just put a ground ball in play.
She's set. Head to the plate.
Again, she leads off with drilling Kenny. Don't know what Rosanna has against the kid in the wheelchair, but that is kind of fucked up.
Here's the windup and the pitch. Swung on. A bouncing ball.
He's done. That's one. So, Lisa Crockett, 285. Should be over 300 with four ribbies. Instead, hits a ground ball to the pitcher.
That little blooper set him running.
That's two down.
Into the windup. Here's the pitch. Swung on.
That didn't break. That was supposed to break down. That did not break in the slightest.
Ready now. And the offering.
That's also supposed to break down. All right. A little better, some contact there, but not great. Not great stuff. Awful swing. Cruising. Not even looking what happened there.
And the offering.
That's a foul. Wind up and the pitch.
Another strike. And the count is 0-2. From the wind up, the delivery. Down she goes.
Big Ange doing everything she can to get the strikeouts. No, why did I do that? Oh, thank God she sucks. All right, left hook. It's gonna look out here. No way she could hit it. Catch the corner.
It's been too long since one and one.
Try that again. Same exact pitch. A little more inside. She squares up.
And popped up.
Pablo. We got an appearance here from NJ Dubs. Thanks for tuning in. What you missed was the Fishes won this game, and then Backyard Baseball completely crashed. Giving the Red Sox hope. It was a 5-2 Fishers win. If you hit escape, it uses more juice. That's wild. Hit the slow-mo on Novar. Alright. So the K record. Under protest. Big Ange had 10.
Timeout.
Okay. We're not playing this whole 4-6 again. We're saved. So the game is now saved in the bottom of the sixth inning with Pablo leading off and the game is tied. Which means one swing of this bat ends it and we go home. What is that pitch? That's not in the zone. That's not a strike. It's not. That's gonna hit him. Pablo just looking for one pitch to hit. She's throwing two that are absolutely unhittable.
From the windup and the pitch. And drove one deep.
That's trouble. That's trouble.
Plays it off the wall.
Get there, Pablo. Get there, Pablo.
Just like I would have done.
So Pablo is now on second base. This game's over. He hit a spitball. Means Sidney Webber with a chance to... So now, again, because normally I never do this. I do it only in the last out of the game. But this game's over. Because Webber is going to rip this ball down the line. You have no choice but to rip this ball down the line.
Ready now and deliver.
So despite the fact that that would have ended the game, and I probably could have sent Pablo home, it was a special pitch. Let's see what we got now.
Here comes Ashley with runners on first and third. Nobody out. She's set. Comes to the plate. A swing. Strike.
Takes the strike on the crazy bunt. Wild. Wild set of circumstances there.
From the windup and the delivery.
And that's your ball game.
It can drive any fielder batty.
So knowing that's your ball game, We have no choice but to do this.
She's running out of options. This is quite a predicament. And the runner is safe.
She doesn't get the tag off.
These kids are really hustling today.
This is quite a predicament.
And Ashley's going to round the bases and score. That's a 5-2 final. That's the same final we would have had had the game counted.
The Fishes have crushed them 5-2.
Everybody's so excited.
That's sweet justice. The RBIs go to somebody else. The stats a little different. Big Ange Delvecchio, still your winning pitcher, giving up only 3 hits with absolutely phenomenal second half baseball. But that's what people come to say. Buried the Sox in the standings with a 4-game lead over the Sox with 8 games to play. Now we get our first non-divisional game. We get a look at the Hornets. We travel to the West Coast now. The Hornets, 500 team. Let's go statistically. Statistically, on the season, a lot of quality hits. 500. Wait, that's my team. Quality hitters. Where's the... I gotta find them now. Hornets. Can't hit for shit. Judy. Bottom of this lineup, batting 562. She should file a complaint with the league. 2 triples, a dinger, 3 doubles, 6 ribs. Only one on the team that could hit the ball. Her and Hannah. Hannah, notoriously quality hitter. But let's get into it. Not my favorite field. Probably my least favorite field. Lineup looks good. We're going to go with a slight change, though. We're putting Pablo at the 1 spot. Green Hornets. See, this makes sense. The Green Hornets. Blue Fishes here. This is an oversight by management. The color scheme is backwards.
Let's play ball. On the mound today is Judy Abunza.
Oh, Judy Abunza. Not who you want on the mound against the Fishes today.
First in line, Pablo Sanchez.
Good news is that Pablito's home run in the first game counted, even with the canceled game. Because that ball is absolute moonshot. So Pablo now home runs in back-to-back games. Ball one,
with nobody out.
So, if Pablo keeps up this absolutely torrid pace that he's on, he's going to finish the season batting around 700 with an unquestionable amount of dingers. That's out of here. Oh, that doesn't count. That's right. Oh, and it falls in play. Which is enough. I don't know if this would count as a home run if he's safe. Oh!
This is quite a predicament. Ball's out of play. All runners advance.
So I think that's an error.
And that marks their debut in today's score.
But I don't know how that's going to be counted. I'm not the statistician here. That should be a triple with an error.
Ready now.
The late break on that ball was vicious. Pablo got real lucky. It sat on top of the dumpster and just slowly fell to the ground. Just give me a heater. Just give me something flat. In the zone. Not a lot of movement. Just going to put the ball in play. Just like that. All it's got to do is fall and it's trouble. Especially on the cement. I'm not trying to do the base running thing to be an a-hole. They're throwing the ball around like an idiot. Sydney Weber. Huge hit last game. Threw the corkscrew and she hit the screaming line drive at the end. Oh, that ball is laced.
That's a slow roller.
Oh, they doubled her up! Doubled up! That means there's a special hit for the Hornets before they even get to the plate. See, Ashley with a much better hit, because that one's also out. It's very green. I said Judy Abunza. I said she needs to complain to management. Now batting 1. Her 562 is up clearly early. Oh no. Oh no. Nice play, Lisa. Nice play, Lisa.
Venetia Goodman.
Kids, one tough cookie, Sonny.
Timeout. Venetia? Venetia. Isn't that Vanessa? Just want that on record that there's no way that's not Vanessa. I guess either works, but I didn't see that coming. Anyway, Venetia. Oh, thought she was getting K'd up. Oh, Big Ange with the comment. When she says she throws pretty fast, you come in with the slowest pitch you got, moving at like 2 miles an hour. I swing over the top every time. Hannah Peavy, the other kid on this team, quality average, could hit the shit out of the ball. No way Angela gets there. She's slow. She got there. So, important to note, there's no errors on the board for the Hornets, meaning that may have counted as a home run for Pablo. Oh, Gretchen Wilson, a pretty good pick, especially in the field. You can see she's the, see where the mouse is, the blonde girl. She's quality on the mound. In the field, rather, sorry. She's not the best ever, but she's pretty good. That's two strikes. You don't want to get a K here. You don't want that special pitch looming. Miss Abuanza. She's been throwing up meatballs, pretty much. But Sally Dobbs. You can't forget that Sally Dobbs is actually not good. She couldn't. She's lying to you. This is somebody who could hit a home run if she wants to, but she doesn't. Puts her focus on hitting. She doesn't put her focus on hitting. She's a pitcher. Pitcher at heart. Just want that call coming back the other way when I get it. That's strike two. Not good when we give Miss Abuanza a couple K's just sitting here left and right. Not what you want. Not what you want from this. Oh, that's crushed. That's crushed. If it's on the top of Mo Aluminum, it's gone. Update. I lied about that. I have not a clue where that ball is, but as long as it doesn't stop rolling, she can advance.
And he advances two bases on a ground rule double.
Shit.
Into second with a standing double.
So that's unfortunate. Next up, which is why Pablo, his ball didn't stop rolling and fell back into the field of play. That's impressive stuff. Ball. Okay. Where did it land? Did it hit him? We needed hit by pitches in this game. Little HBPs. Because a lot of kids would get fucking beamed in this game. Swing batter!
Here's the pitch. Strike! One and two.
Whoop, 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 whoop. Oh, man. So, if I think it's remotely close, my strategy is always swing at the special pitches. The worst that happens is it's a strike or even a K. But you make contact and put that ball in play. Chance you get on base, you're getting that special hit. Oh, my God. No way Angel gets picked off doing this. I tried to just get the throw away from Kenny. Oh, that's... You know what? Keep the juice for the pitching. It's fine. So, David's daughter. Baseball. She's a team player. She's got a lot of energy. Not the most talented, but she's great in the field. Great. She's a good glue player. You know, she keeps the team together. And also, she's fast as fuck, boy. Holy shit. Holy shit. She flew down the first baseline.
That's a foul.
That's on. So, I think we got a Pablo at bat in the next inning. So we'll get an idea of if he hit a home run in this third straight game. There's two down. Carlos Ocampo. I hit him with a little off-speed stuff. That's one. So, Angel Delvecchio posting a sub-2 ERA 6 games through the season. Something you don't usually get in the backyard leagues. She has to have... She's averaging about 7 Ks a game. She's pitched almost every inning for the Fishes. Okay. Oh, that's right. Pablo's batting first. I switched it up. So with Pablo up first, we will see in the very next at-bat if that's 3 straight with a dinger. Part of me just wants Lisa to get out. Because, again, she could have been the hero, but the powers that be didn't want it to happen. That's one out. They counted it. Pablo, with 3 home runs in his last 3 games, took a 290, 300 average to 600. Torrid pace the last few. Oh, I got happy feet. I swung way too early. If I let that come in, that ball is, that's a moonshot. That's trouble because Gretchen runs right into the other girl. Still had no problem catching it. Okay, sure. Just Pablo Sanchez. Leg it, Pete. Leg it. Only Pete Wheeler hits a pop-up to the catcher and gets 2 bags. Go! Go! No way! They're not catching him. Woo! Alright. We'll take the triple. Take the 3-bagger from Petey Wheels. Everyone who's tuning in, thanks for tuning in. We're in game 7 of the season. Fish is looking 5-1 in the season. Fresh, fresh season so far. A lot of games to play. First place in the AL East. We took the place of the Yankees. With our only loss in the season coming to the O's in game 1. When, I'll be honest with you, I couldn't hit the ball for shit. Lost a 1-0 game. Just couldn't hit the ball. The settings in this game, we have the hardest difficulty. We're taking off the pitch meter. We're taking off the ball zone. Trying to not have too much of an edge. Mostly because this was a kid's game from 2000. And I'm no longer a kid in the 2000s. But here we are. With all that said, winning the World Series in this game is still not an easy feat. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. No, no. Need to get her out. Okay. If you give up a hit on that pitch, they have a special hit. Also, now I'm thinking that they have a special hit anyway. This team had a double play in the first inning. So they have a special hit. Haven't used it yet. It's possible it was on a swing and miss, but more likely than not, with the computer on this difficulty, they're saving it for something. My hopes is that they didn't. Alright, 0-1. Fastball here. Make the catch. Ashley Weber, 1-2-3 inning. Cruising. Angel Delvecchio is probably the best pitcher in all of backyard baseball. Is that right? She's throwing a no-hitter? Says she's throwing a no-hitter right now. And she's safe because there's nobody to cover first base. Not gonna leg it. So, Ashley picks up a couple bags here. Sick. Dante Robinson, very quietly having an okay season. Pitcher's getting there. Get back. Don't get back. Go. Floor it. Not you. first and second.
Belly dog steps in.
You know what? This is a perfect setup for... In most scenarios, I would bunt with Miss Dobbs here. The problem is, Kenny Kawaguchi is up next, who's batting sub 100. I can't hit with Sally. Can't hit with Kenny. Not really doing a whole lot there. What I can do, though. No, don't do that. Square up. We square up. Just throw a strike here. You strike out on a bunt. And I was wrong about the lineup. Oh, it's Angela DeVecchio. She's got the ability to put this ball to the moon. So Angela DeVecchio has a lot of pop in the bat. She's pretty good. She's got some skills here. That ball's at my eyes, and I swung. There's a special pitch coming my way right now. I can feel it. That's a hell of an infield. Oh, Kenny actually got over 100 with the hit today. That's an improvement. And unless they get a force out, he's safe again. Because there's nobody on the bag. So, this is her second game in a row. In the fourth inning. With a chance to have a big hit. With the bases loaded. Last time it didn't count. Remember what I said about the special pitches? I lied. If it's that far out of the zone, you let it go. Ideal is if Lisa walks, we get Pablo back up with the bases juiced. And that's what you want, a chance to put this game away early. And instead, Judy Abuanza is just throwing slow balls down the pipe that I can't hit. I don't know if I'm getting happy feet and swinging way too early. I think so. I think I'm on top of these balls. So if I slow it down a bit. Slowed it down a bit. However, not enough. Okay, so.
Timeout.
I'm going to save this game. Because the last time we played a game, it crashed. Which I'm going to focus on a lot. And we're bottom four right now. What is that, Pete? Oh my god! Pete Wheeler! I stand by, there's no way her name is Venetia. Everyone, thanks for joining the chat. Appreciate the views. We're here in the middle of the season. This is game 7. We got the Fishers at the Hornets. Pablo with a catch. For those of you just tuning in, not here to jinx anything. 6-inning ball game. Very important to know that. Oh, no. Catch it, Pablo. Well, disregard everything I said. I was about to say that Big Ange DeVecchio. Oh, this girl's done. Done. Really? So, I ruined all of that. I was about to say that Big Ange DeVecchio was perfect. That might count. No, it's not going to count as an error because Pablo's whiffed. And that was coming sooner or later. And we went from perfect. Oh, no. The wheels are coming off real quick. We went from perfect to the game. The go-ahead run for the Hornets is on second base. Rough 36 seconds for the Fishes. However, there are two outs. And we got some dumb pitches. We're going to hit it with a corkscrew? No. Big Ange wants to throw the spitball. I trust the pitcher a lot here in these circumstances. Popped up. Kenny, just catch the ball. It's right at you. got out of the inning. That got real scary. They got two hits. It went from a perfect game for Big Ange. And as I open my mouth, that's on me. I'll take responsibility for that loss, for losing the perfect game. That was low. Okay. So, Pablo, absolute fire. Three straight games with home runs. The depth perception in this game, though, was very difficult, because when a ball is low, it's tough to tell if it's clipping the zone. So that's clearly out. However, if it sits up there, it's only a double unless I could round the bases beforehand. Fall, 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 keep falling. Son of a bitch! Because if that falls and he scores before the double is called, he gets the home run. The problem is I couldn't round the bases quick enough. It needed to fall. Pablo, again, hitting the shit out of the ball.
Shoot.
Oh, shoot. Again, everybody who's joined the chat, thank you for tuning in. Really do appreciate the views. If you like the content, follow. Whoop! Knocked her out with a hit pitch. If you like the content, please follow, because we're posting more backyard baseball throughout the rest of the season.
Addy comes in to score. Addy's
whoop! Here we go, fish. Here we go, fish. So, we do have both Weber sisters here. It's very important to note. Both of them have absolutely stupid increases in their statistics because they're on the same team. If you recall, when you draft them, they say, pick my sister. And then something else. But
that little blooper sent him running.
That gets Pete over to third. You get a chance to get the three runs here, go up big. Chance to close out the Hornets. Judy Abuenza, 46 pitches. That's a lot. I am very sad, though, and disappointed in myself for talking about the perfect game. You don't do that. You don't talk about a perfect game when a pitcher's got it going. Wow. Gretchen Hasselhoff laying out for that one. I didn't think she had it. Come on, Dante. Let me try this. The suicide squeeze. Dante running down the line. No one's there to get him. That's a run. What a bunt by Dante. That is great action. You don't see that kind of play in any other game. You watch baseball today, you get some of the best hitters in the league that if you ask them to bunt, couldn't if their life depended on it. But Dante, team player, man eats a hot dog or a hamburger before every at-bat. I don't know how he decides which one. But hot dog or hamburger for every at-bat, hustles, team guy, not a big stats guy, puts the team before himself. And that's what matters. That's what's going to help you win World Series. Is that middle of the lineup guy who brings it all together. Sally Dobbs catches that inside the line. And this girl was running into the newspaper garbage. Don't totally understand that.
On her way in with a double.
Nice one.
Oh, alright, threw it to third. Okay. Angela Delvecchio with a chance to blow this game open. It's 3-0. Looking at 5. Maybe 6 with the right hit. Alright, 3-0. There's no way Angel is safe here. I don't think so. Carlos Ocampo up. Alright. Only 2 Ks for Angel Delvecchio this game. Kind of a slow game for her in the stats department. So, we're not getting 27 up, 27 down baseball immortality. Although, I'll be real with you, it's 18 up, down.
baseball. And he goes after it. Chuck's
yeah.
the first. They go up.
Ryan Vanderhoek. Big Ange not getting the K's this game, but efficient. Efficient in a way that you can't really teach. I don't think she's throwing a single ball. Get there. Get there, Kenny. 1, 2, 3 inning. Kenny Kawaguchi taking his average from .8 to 176 today. 2 for 2. That's big for the brand. You get a guy at the bottom of the lineup that puts the ball in play and gets on base. You know, there's no easy outs then. Foul. Yeah. 176 still isn't it. But you get to 200, 250. As your 8-9 hitters, it's quality. Saw that coming. Mile away. Lisa Crockett. No disrespect, Lisa. Don't really care what you do here. Prefer you don't strike out, but don't care. That's trouble.
Watch your kneecaps on those
daters. Oh, that's a fair ball. We need to check that on the replay. That looked like a fair ball. That's foul. But it, so that ball bounced. Because it bounced, I'm pretty confident crossed the bag. Could be wrong. But such is life. Well, that's it. Doesn't get it. For everybody tuning in again, thank you. Thank you. Appreciate the views. If you support the fishes, please drop a follow as we continue this run towards a World Series ring and a memories that these kids will never forget. And most importantly, Lisa Crockett will never forget. Because Lisa is somebody who I've never drafted before, doesn't deserve to be on this team, all around kind of stinks. But they said the team's finances were in order the past few seasons. We need somebody to step up and do it. Lisa looked like the girl to do it. Pablo just leaving his stomach hanging out is just top baseball quality. Good pitch, Miss Abuanza. Wasn't ready for it, but good pitch.
Ready now, and delivered.
You can't throw me a breaking ball. It doesn't break.
Oh, your back out swinging like that.
Yeah, I'm aware, Vinny.
Ready now, and the throw. Ball one.
Good eye, kid. Good eye, Pablo. 2 for 3. He goes 3 for 4 with another dinger. He's jumping over 6. That'd be big. Son of a bitch! Well, at least it was the bottom of the top of the sixth. He's the last out of the game. For the fishes, at least. No fancy pitches. We're not listening to Vinny. She wants the left hook. You throw this up and in. It's either flat and he crushes it, or he gets jammed. So, Judy Abuanza, only person that seemed like could hit the shit out of the ball, was batting .590 coming into the game. Drops down to significantly less. So, Vanessa Goodman is up now. Not Vanessa. It's Vanessa Goodman. And this is going to be our last batter of the night. We saved it just in case, again, the game craps out. We got the special pitches. And unfortunately for Vanessa, we got it again. Ow. That's kind of embarrassing. Is that three? Is that three? Oof. Ange can't gain the zone. She's got to throw it inside. Here we go. Throws the slow ball. Gets the K. Gets the win. As expected. So this happens in waves. I don't understand it whatsoever. Luckily, we're right back in it. Game crashed again. Luckily, since it happened already, I'm prepped. We're back in the bottom of the sixth. Vanessa Goodman's up again. Pops up immediately. Pablo is right there, ready to make the catch. And this time it counts. I don't totally understand that. Come playoff time, that's going to be top tier frustrating. Looking back, we're in the American League East. Boston, absolutely buried. Done. Six games back, out. Fishes move it with another win. Jays, the old school logo, like that logo, pick up a win. Orioles, another win. AL East is just... Oh, actually, the Orioles stink. I take it back. The Blue Jays, two losses in the season. The only two losses to the Fishes. And the only team to get runs against the Fishes in both games. The Sox got shut out once. The O's got shut out once. But the Blue Jays put up a 4-spot and a 2-spot. Just looking ahead, postseason. We got a long way to go. Four losses. So, as far as the postseason is concerned, the Fishes have a 3-game lead over the O's, the Wombats, Tigers, Indians, Rangers, and Hornets for the wild card if they don't clinch the division over the Jays. You got a chance to play a lot of those teams. You get to play the Royals, you get to play the Wombats, you get to play the A's, Rangers. There's a chance that by week 10, this team has got a spot clinched, and they keep rolling. Quick look around the league statistics before we close it down for the evening. Pete Wheeler leading the team batting.
Batting average. If a player gets a hit...
I don't need Sunny Day to tell me what batting average is. But, .590. Pretty good from Pete. Well, this is what I wanted. This is actually what I wanted. Home runs. Really? Hold on. Pablo only has 3 home runs, so his last 3 in his last 3 games, the only ones. 9 is the league leader. Hits, quality, they're up there. Lindsey Felgate on the Expos, absolutely crushing this season. Pete and Pablo with 2 triples speeds. Pablo with 9 ribbies. Runs scored, okay. Lindsey's absolutely crushing the game. Here we go, strikeouts. 56 from Angelo DelVecchio. ERA. The humongous bombers, Esmeralda Heyman and Wing Kwan of the Rockies, are both having great seasons as well. But Angelo DelVecchio was right there for the ERA. We're going to look to see if she could, take the lead here. Win herself a Cy Young. But everyone who tuned in, thank you for watching. For those of you who didn't, we'll post on YouTube shortly. You want to continue with the season? And thanks for picking the nose. I will see you all tomorrow with games 8 and 9.